Well, good morning. How is everybody? Doing well? It's great to see you here. It's nice to be out, isn't it? And breathing fresh air and being able to socialize and reconnect to people that you haven't seen in months, possibly. So we're going to get this thing started. You know, I know there's different ways you can do a luncheon. So we're going to do it this way because that's the way we're going to do it. We want to get to know who everybody is. So there are people here that know each other. There are people here that don't know who some people are. So we're going to give everybody the opportunity to stand up and say, hey, I'm this person, and this is what I do, and this is where I'm at, and this is how long I've done it. Okay? So just like a 30-second quick introduction. For those of you that don't know me, as Mr. Clark said, my name is Greg Calger. I've been in the event industry about 18 years, and I've had many capacities. I'm a venue manager, I'm an officiant, I'm a DJ, so I've got a lot of different things that I can share with you in a one-to-one basis that can help you understand, you know, what the industry is doing and how it's working and, you know, why does this person do that or do this. But I've had a lot of fun. There's nothing like being a part of someone's most special day in their life, right? And that's why we're here. It's a tough business. There's demands, obviously. There's pandemics that screw us all up. But we're going to get through it. We're going to survive. And I think 2021 is just going to be hang on, catch your breath when you can, and let's get it done, okay? So that's a little bit about me. So I'm going to go back this direction and start off with our venue. Now, you don't have the short amount of time they have. You take as much time as you want.
Thanks, Greg. My name's Nikki Codell. I'm the event sales manager here at Pyramid Hill Sculpture Park and Museum. I've been here a little over six years. I've been in the industry for 26 years. Little bit about Pyramid Hill. It's a 330-plus acre sculpture park. We have over 70 monumental sculptures throughout the park. We have four venues that we hold receptions at, ceremonies near each venue, but also all throughout the park. Multiple weekends, I have all four going at the same time, so very busy. But we have seven lakes with the sculptures. Best way to experience the park is with an art cart. You can go around the park in the grass, right up to the sculptures. A lot of the weddings like to utilize those to go around for pictures because you can get to a lot of the really unique and cooler spots for your pictures with the carts. So it's a big benefit for that. This is the Ancient Sculpture Museum. Make sure you also go inside to the antiquities area so you can see all the ancient Greek, Roman, Etruscan, Egyptian, and a few Syrian pieces that we do have. Some date back to 1550 BC. The lodge is over here. It's more of a rustic cabin feel. The pavilion is up past the visitor center. It's an open-air venue that can hold up to 350. And then we also have the underground home that the founder lived in, the Pyramid House. That one can do about 130, 140 people. And that's where the whole park got its start. It started out as 40 acres. The underground home was built on that. And then he just acquired pieces around as it came available and just tried to get as much as he could so developers didn't get a hold of it. And now we're over 330. And one thing a lot of people don't know about is we're soon to be over 500 acres. It's called Fortified Hill. You'd have to look it up. The Harry T. Wilkes Family Foundation and multiple people went in together to purchase this land at auction. It's an ancient Indian burial ground, and so we're going to be clearing that out and to help preserve it and do what anyone should do with the land. So that'll put us over 500 acres, and we'll be doing groundbreaking for that in 2022, I believe, or 23. So. But yeah, thank you guys all for coming, and hopefully you stick around and either drive around through the park or use the art carts to go around too.
Helping us today is one of our party pleasers guys, Mr. John Getz, and he's back there making it all happen. And what you don't see is Rhonda is back with us, and Rhonda is hosting everybody that's on the feed right now. So she's chatting with them and having a good time, probably saying something crazy about me as well. But that's all right. We're just so glad that Rhonda's back, and we'll talk more about that in just a little bit. So it's time for lunch. Who's hungry? Okay, some of you are. So here's how we're going to do this to figure out which table gets released first, okay? Where did the term charger come from?
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, I'd like to invite you to put your hands together and welcome to the podium Indiana Jones himself, the owner of TGF Holdings, Mr. Tim Fritz.
All right. So I thought Indiana Jones, I think you know we're DJs, so at heart, so I think Indiana Jones is only appropriate. It's an adventure, right? So here I strolled up here looking cool with my iPad, and then I'll whip out my paper notes. So, wow. Thank you for being here today. And thank you for the venue here. I mean, there could not be a better venue and setting to be COVID compliant and just having a great afternoon. So I'd like to once again thank all of our sponsors and vendors for doing a great job. So everything is perfect. I feel like a standard's been set with the perfect wedding guide, and we want to make sure that we're right there. I thank all of you for coming out. You're always fearful. All right, it's COVID. You know, there'll probably be 12 at us. I remember when Jack was started to do meetings up in Dayton. The first one we had was at a venue, and we had all this stuff set up, and it ended up being like 8 or 10 of us maybe at one little table. But that was the start, and now Perfect Wedding Guide is really huge in Dayton. I want to, I first want to thank Jack Phelps. Jack has helped me and my businesses over the years and just been there through thick and thin. And I think when he took that brand, that PWG brand, it was going downhill. And I mean, I flat out told him on that boat, I'm like, Jack, you're on a sinking ship. This is not good. And, I'm a crazy guy. He's calm, cool, collected. And so, he's like, we've got this. And what he's done with his tenure with this brand of Perfect Wedding Guide is just been amazing. And it is, I was fearful of it going away. I was fearful of what was going to happen with that Perfect Wedding Guide brand, because it's been there with me my entire time as a owning a company and stuff. And I just would like to applaud Jack and what he has done for all of us and the PWG brand at this time. So, I'll tell you, I'm excited. We've been through this COVID thing, and really, it's been like a timeout. It's been like, all right, timeout. Everybody stop what you're doing. And I don't maybe mind stopping as long as everybody else is stopping too. It's like you're afraid when you stop that everybody else just keeps going. But there was a timeout. And that timeout really, I've sat and talked with Steve. Steve, he's a lot like me. He's just a loose, all over the place guy. And to be able to have time to stop and think and reboot and it has been a great time for I know the companies that TGF Holdings has to, you know, reset and think, well, how can we do this and what can we do? You know, Jeff and I, Jeff, you know, runs Party Pleasers, and you know, we got all these guys not doing anything. What are we gonna do? We ended up building about 140 Pinterest boards for venues. You know, we went into the studio and did training videos and put together materials to prepare and train and do things. And it was like, all right. And then, you know, here I'm thinking, you know, I've got staff that aren't doing a lot of things, and all of a sudden this perfect wedding guide's available. There could be an opportunity for me. I feel like an opportunity came and passed, and I thought, crap, I missed out on that. And when all of a sudden the opportunity was there for me to own the perfect wedding guide brand in this market, I mean, it's like, you know what? I've got people that are right now wondering what we could be doing. And, you know, I called Jamie, and we started talking about it. And we were about a month in talking and discussing. And, you know, Jeff is sort of he's my stabilizer in stuff. And, you know, he's, you know, warning about, you know, do we take on too much? What do we do? And all that kind of stuff. And Jeff's told me, he said, Tim, I really think that the perfect wedding guide could be the wind in the sails of the Event Connections and could be the wind in what a lot of what we're doing. And there's an opportunity. And, you know, I'm a person that throughout my career have taken advantage of opportunities when they've come my way. And the opportunity to be able to be part of this brand and continue the tradition that it has. And I'll tell you right now, I'm not that good. I'm not that smart. I'm just really good at putting good people around me and putting together a good team. And I think what I want to talk to you a little bit about is opportunity and team. You know, I felt I got a lot of people not busy right now. And maybe this would be a great time to take on that perfect wedding guide brand and put a lot of us to work, getting going and get up to speed and doing things. And so that's exactly what we did. I wanted to give you a little bit of my history. I started in the wedding industry. I'd been in the corporate market for about 30 years with one company, and I started doing this little DJ thing on the side. And, you know, it was a little crazy money, you know, and stuff. And the first event was in 1999. And in 2000, I thought, you know, this is fun. I like this, you know, like maybe I can make some money at this. And one of the first outreaches that I did, opportunity that I took advantage of, was Fred's dad. I called Bridal-Rama, and oh my goodness, I mean, you got Fred on the phone. I mean, Fred was, and I mean, it was like, he's my best friend now, you know, and I mean, Fred is like, and he's like, yeah, Tim, we can do this and we can do that. And I went to my first Bridal-Rama bridal show, and I took my two daughters that are here today with me. I took them there, and they were like, Dad, this is, you know what? We ought to, and Fred had some extra booth space, so he said, if you want to use that, Tim, Dad, let's, you know, so next thing you know, I mean, we've got the booth, and we got going on, I got two great-looking ladies helping me, and boom, we're off and running. And you know what? That opportunity that was presented to me at Bridal-Rama, I got with Fred. And Fred and Bridal-Rama has been part of my team. That was an opportunity. And I've been in every Bridal-Rama show ever since that day. And that show, I don't care if it had a lot of brides or no brides, or if it was whatever, you know what? If there's not brides there, there's vendors there. And I got time to talk to some vendors and stuff. And I've never, ever, but the Bridal-Rama has been the most successful show for us ever. And Fred's in the same business I'm in. I'm in the DJ business. And I really admire him for what he's done in that industry. So that's an opportunity that you know, I went and took advantage of. Kathy Peach Lucas called me one day. Here I am working, running Party Please out of the basement of my house. You know, people were coming to the basement. Oh, you guys are in the basement of your house, you know? And my house was the party place to be, but we had a big system, and I had teenagers that you know, loved having their friends over to my house. But I was in the basement of my house, and Kathy Peach Lucas said, Tim, there's something up in Dayton where they've got a building up here you might be able to come into. And I thought, well, you know, there might be a chance to have an office outside. So I went to Dayton, and I put an office up there in a little building. And we were there with a thing called the Dayton Bridal Connection. Let me back up one little thing. When I was at Bridal-rama, Fred and them introduced me to PWG. And Lori Robinson, who was the salesperson, is Patricia from Patricia's Cakes, was the first salesperson I ever said. And you know what I told her? I told her, I said, I just don't need to advertise. I got more business than I need. I really don't need it. And you know, she's like, well, you know, if that's the case, then you could probably raise your prices. You could probably charge more if you're doing more. You could probably, well, you know what? That's right. And she talked to me from a business standpoint, as a salesperson, and told me about that opportunity. And you know what I did? I took advantage of that opportunity. I brought PWG, I brought Lori, and I still talk with Lori to this day about her coming and seeing me in my basement of my house and stuff, and took advantage of that opportunity. And I started advertising with Perfect Wedding Guide. Well, you know what? At Bridal-rama, I wanted to do something really cool. So I thought, well, we set up a reception out in the lobby. Fred's dad says, hey, let's do it. You know, you can set up a reception out there. I said, well, I need to make it look like a reception. They said, you know what? I know this florist. Lori said, I know this florist, you know, named Fassler Florist, that is so, I mean, they're a lot like you. They're crazy like you. They'd be in on that. So sure enough, they introduced me to Fassler Florist. And next thing you know, at the next show, I mean, we're in the lobby, we're dancing out there, it looks like a reception, and all the other vendors say, what are you doing? You know, what's happening? But we were making that alive. But you know, that relationship with Fassler Florist has been so valuable to me. So valuable to me over all these years. And I cherish that relationship. And they've been part of my daughter's weddings, and I've referred them business and stuff, and that relationship. I will tell you right now, I don't think I've ever been to a PWG luncheon that I have not met somebody, got a lead, did something. One year, the biggest event we ever did was University of Miami, and it was a fundraiser for when they were building out this whole big thing, and I got that from a PWG luncheon. So, and I've told Jeff many times, we are fools if we don't make those luncheons. You know, if we don't take advantage of that opportunity. So anyhow, you know, going up to Dayton and becoming part of that was a thing called the Dayton Bridal Connection. And you know, people like to be part of groups, a tribe, a church almost. And we were part of this thing called the Dayton Bridal Connection. Well, I did not realize, but there was some problems there, and next thing you know, I mean, our group's being evicted. You know, I mean, we're behind in rent on this building by about 40 grand is what I was heard, the main controller of that. And so the people that own the building said, hey, they're behind, this thing's gonna dissolve. And I'm like, wait a second. I mean, I just got up here. I got this nice, cool office, and all these people around me are moving out. I mean, my experience is turning around companies and things, turning around businesses. I at one time had 230 stores that I was over, and I thought, we can make this happen. But let me tell you what I think. You know, I often wondered, what would have made Party Pleasers more successful quicker? And the things are, one, a professional place to meet people. Two, synergy with other vendors. Other vendors talking about you. You don't have to talk about yourself. other people talking about you is going to make you more prosperous. And then a little bit of help, and I call a little bit of help, is I did not want to be in a place where I had to be there all the time, because when the door closed, the place closed up. So that's why I thought having a concierge, somebody that could help that person with that cake that needs to be picked up by somebody, or those photos that need to be picked up with somebody, or somebody that can talk about that company when they're not there. And so I thought that'd be a great, great thing. And then the other thing I thought was, I thought, you know what? This wedding industry is great, but golly, that corporate business. I love that corporate business. I mean, that corporate business repeats. They come back the next year, and you know, those wedding people, only if they get a divorce, and we don't want that to happen, you know, do I do them again? But the corporate business repeats. So I thought, well, what could we do? What could we do to get that corporate? And also, I would like to be able to do a bar mitzvah or a quinceanera or something like that. So that's where we came out and created the Event Connections. The Event Connections was corporate and social. And I thought that I had, being in the wedding industry, how can I approach the corporate business and how can I approach that? And that's where the Event Connection was born. It was born out of an opportunity. The opportunity was that the Dayton Bridal Connection was closing. That building was going to be emptied with people. And I convinced that landlord that I can keep these people here. Let me help. And so we jumped in, created the Dayton, the Event Connections. I took a 20-year lease on this building. I needed to invest about $100,000 to make the building look anything decent, because it was in rough shape. And if I'm going to take that kind of a gamble, you know, I thought I need 20 years on this building. And a lot of people said, 20 years. Well, the nice thing was they couldn't sell that building because of my lease, so they sold it to me. So the opportunity came to buy that building, and I took advantage of that opportunity. I took advantage of bringing that in. You know, now you have this building with all this space. What the heck are you going to do with it? I thought, you know, let's make offices for people. Let's make flex space available, and let's do other things. Let's make a venue where we can train people, train businesses, have business networking. And I asked Greg to come in and run that business. And so he's been running the Event Connections. It's about 80 members strong, 80 members that are part of that. And it's helpful in different ways. You know, and now a person can come to us and instantly have an office in Dayton, the Reading Bridal District, and also in Columbus through what was the Event Connections. That was an opportunity that I took advantage of. When I went to create the Event Connections up, I asked for help. I went to Jack and I said, Jack, I need to partner up. You know, I need a better piece to this. The Event Connections are all right. I want the corporate and social, but I need the power that PWG has with its brand and stuff. And so Jack partnered with me and worked with me and helped me with bridal shows. And Rhonda has just been such a big help in doing those emails and doing those campaigns and doing all those things. And I so appreciate how he helped that grow and developed. I will tell you that the previous two owners, I've known the previous two owners of PWG, and they've all been great people, great business, great coaches, and we want to continue that tradition of helping and developing and making the market better. I don't know if you realize the DJs in Cincinnati get more money because Fred pressed that market and made a DJ. If you want a decent DJ, it's usually going to be $1,000 or more. And that's because of what Fred did in raising the entire market here. I'll tell you right now, that's not the case in Columbus. In Columbus, there's not that pressure. There's a lot more. We seek to raise the entire industry in what we do here. And if that's providing a professional place for you to be, if that's networking with some other people and people talking with you, if that's giving you leads, if that's giving you marketing, I will tell you, Jeff Clark has taken party pleasers from, you know, just a few events we were doing to last year over 1,200 events, you know. So we know where you're at. And the tools that we've been using and having for party pleasers and the Event Connections and the companies that I've had are tools that have been in place. When the opportunity came for me to own the Event Connections, And to be truthful, I mean, to own the PWG, to be able to get Rhonda. Rhonda is so incredible. And she's just amazing. And the other staff that I had to be able to bring these people in, we've been able to put together an incredible group of people and an incredible team. And I wanted to be able to, a lot of you are wondering, what's going on? You know, how in the world is Jeff Clark involved in this thing? I mean, he's at our place DJing stuff all the time. You know, he's got those 25 DJs running all over God's creation in Cincinnati, Dayton, Columbus. You know, what's going on? Well, we've made some changes. We've decided, and I'll let Jeff explain this to you some, but we have decided that we are going to, make the event connections it's going to be more nationwide and hopefully maybe worldwide. And Jeff's heading that up. We are going to take a part of that business that we've had as far as providing office space and other tools and other email campaigns and Facebook marketing and all those things, and we're going to bring those in under a thing called my brain's going crazy here. Under TEC marketing. So TEC marketing is going to be that piece of that. And we want to be able to help people market in all branches of business, even though our roots are in the event industry, but we want to be able to help anybody with any of their branding and doing things. So we've put together a team, and I just wanted to, for you to, the first, I want to just give Jeff Clark. Jeff is now the COO of the eventconnections.com. So don't think of it as a building. Think of it as a website. And Jeff is just going to say maybe a couple words about what he's doing there with that.
So like Tim said, I'll talk from back here to save time. Like he said, the Event Connections was a building. It was more centralized to the building and vendors in the building, and then they were on a website. But what we've done is now we've pulled that, and we're in the process of building a beautiful directory site for you. And what I learned as a vendor, as a wedding vendor, is there's a lot of market out there that I don't get to reach maybe with the corporate world. The corporate world, the social world. I'm spending big dollars on other websites, other directories, and they're not getting me anywhere in this corporate world. So the Event Connections is designed to touch beyond just the wedding world. That's going to connect you over more to your corporate clients and hopefully bring you some corporate business, and we're designing it as such. So hopefully as we launch that, that'll be something we can talk about. That's coming down the road. It's still being developed. The website's in creation, so we'll have more to talk about there. But I do want to invite you. Another place is on Facebook. There's a group called it's called Event Professionals. And I know a lot of you guys are already members of that. But the thought there is, we are in Cincinnati, and we all kind of get in our little ruts of how we do things. I know as a DJ, it's like, I think, I have to do the toast after dinner, and then I'm supposed to do the cake cutting. Or Fred probably does it a little different. Toad probably does it a little different, too. I don't know. But let's create a space. What I'm wanting to do there is create a space where not just within our markets, but I can ask guys in Nashville, what do you guys do? How do you do it? Or maybe the question of, hey, what CRM are you guys using to manage your clients, other DJs out there across the country? What do you know that I don't know? Hey, maybe you running a bridal show can teach me something on how to manage clients or market within that group. So I encourage you to join that group. Of course, those are free, but that's a Facebook group just called Event Professionals, and love to have you in there. And if you know event pros in other markets, really is what we're looking for, to bring those in there so that we can get other perspectives. So thanks, Tim.
I do want to let you know, there are those members that are part of the Event Connections right now. Everything's still in place. Everything's right there. The website is still up. We aren't halfway in between anything. There is some other stuff that we're doing, but it is right there. So don't be fearful. We know too the things with the Perfect Wedding Guide launch and the community that's created there. We want to preserve that. We don't there's certain things. So right now I'd like to introduce someone that, back when we were 20 years old, I was running a Radio Shack store, and they said, hey, we got this trainee that we'd like to bring in. I'm like, all right, who is he? You know, and they say, well, it's a guy named Greg Cowger. So this redheaded guy comes into my store up in Dayton over on Burkhart. And that was when we were both young with a lot of hair and a little thinner. And Greg and I have had just unbelievable success, you know, in different businesses and things together. And I've asked him, I thought, you know, I looked at Jack's personality, and I just loved the sincerity that Jack has, the willingness Jack was to do that. And I said, Greg, I think this is a great opportunity. And Greg said he was willing to take on the challenge. So I'd like to bring back up, if you would, Greg Cowger, PWG director.
So we're in September. Thank God the year's almost over. What have we learned in 2020? We've learned that deposit doesn't mean anything legally. Retainer is the new word. We've learned that acts of God means nothing, but civil authority means everything. Okay, we've learned a lot. We've learned how to wear masks, elegant, beautiful masks. We've learned a lot of things, okay? And running a business, especially in 2020, has been a challenge. And there's so many things that we need to do right to keep ourselves forefront in the industry. We need to have a Facebook page. We need to have an Instagram, whatever they are. We need to do this. We need to do that. We need to email market. We need to do this and that. And I've been there. I had my own company, my own DJ company, before I joined the Party Pleasers team. And it's tough. How do I get all this done? So what we've done is we've created TEC marketing. And we've created it based upon a lot of what the Phelps Group or Phelps Marketing was doing. And we grabbed Rhonda. Thank God we grabbed Rhonda. Okay? And she's in here working and making things happen. And she's going to help you get all of those things accomplished that you don't have time for. The email campaigns, Facebook campaigns, targeted marketing, carousel ads, all these fun things. And if you're not familiar with some of those terms, let's talk about it later, okay? But there are some things we have in place also for you, and Tim's hit on a lot of them already. We have that business address. When I started my DJ business, it was just like Tim. It was out of my house, okay? Today's people are savvy. Today's consumers are very savvy. First thing they're going to do is look you up on Google. And if it shows up as a residence, not that that's terrible, but it's not as professional as having a business address. Okay? So we can take care of getting you a business address. So mail comes in. We can give you a mailbox. Maybe you got products, like Tim said. Maybe you got a cake that needs to be picked up. Maybe you got photos or something. We're going to have a concierge there to help you. And not in Dayton and not in Cincinnati, but in Columbus as well. All three cities. So your business that is Cincinnati-based or Dayton-based now can now be a three-city organization. When they Google that, they're probably going to look a little bit deeper into what you are and who you are. So one of the neat things that's coming in is podcast studios, okay? Tim mentioned we did a ton of video production for Party Pleasers in this downtime. So we have the ability now that you can come into one of our studios and sit down and do a podcast in a professional environment with super Wi-Fi and all the stuff you need to make it happen, okay? And then we're also going to collaborate with some other individuals and do commercials. Maybe not TV commercials, but social media commercials that you could put out. Okay, maybe you need a headshot. So you need a professional photographer to give you a headshot and make you look good. All of that we're going to be doing for you through TEC marketing. But that's all I'm going to say about that right now. I'm just going to set the worm out into the water and see if any fish come by and want to talk. Okay, we have brought in today now a great friend, I feel. Jamie Kinder. She is the national sales manager for PWG. And I don't want to take any more time away from her, so she has as much time as possible to tell her story and what PWG is doing now to make your business survive in the years to come. Would you welcome Jamie Kinder?
Thank you. Yes, I changed. Testing. Okay, it's on. I didn't touch the button. I'm really, really, really glad to be here. And yes, I changed my hair color. Same face, different hair. Many of you ladies will appreciate that I decided to stop fighting so hard against gray, so I'm going to give in. I'm giving in. So anyway, I probably need a new headshot really soon. But I will tell you that, yeah, this started out with Tim and with Greg and their team. We had a lot of conversations and a lot of back and forth, and they have become friends. And what's even better than that, you know, you can make friends, but when you realize that you found the people that can best fulfill a role and be of service to their community, and we found that with them. You know, the event connection, we've thought always as what we do being a partnership with wedding professionals. So definitely they have everything it takes, and then some, I believe. I actually got to tour the Event Connection yesterday, and I had heard about it, looked it up, but there was nothing like actually going there and walking through that experience and seeing what you have created for your community of wedding professionals. That's impressive. Before I expect that you'd want to listen to much of what I have to say, I'll give you a reason to. I actually have been with Perfect Wedding Guide for almost 9 years. And can everyone hear me okay? Because I feel like I'm kind of yelling, but is this okay? All right. I've been with Perfect Wedding Guide 9 years, February 1st. And we are a proud, family-owned and operated national company. We didn't start that way, though. So I back in 2011, my brother and I, Jeremy, one of our owners, we were taking a drive to our parents' house for some event, and he was telling me how he was looking into probably buying this company, and I'm like, oh, that's cool. Okay. He's like, no. Like, I want you to be part of this. And I'm like, nah, I'm good. I like what I'm doing. And he knows me, and he knows my strengths, and he knows my weaknesses. So he brought me in. I finally said, because I didn't really believe him. So he brought me in. I said, if you absolutely go forward with this, if you do, that's great. You betcha. I'll jump in and I'll help and I'll serve the St. Louis market. So he did. He closed. He and our parents. So I'm one of four. I'm going to tell you that for a reason. Because our youngest sister, Cassandra, she was with the previous owner of St. Louis, which was at the time a franchise model. And the previous owner wanted to sell. Okay, so she said, this is an amazing company. I didn't even really know what she did. I had no idea. So she took the opportunity to our family, my brother, parents, and there was a decision to go ahead and buy. So we now had my parents, my brother, owner of St. Louis franchise. Okay, that was fun. And we realized we had a lot of work to do. We had a community to build, and that's who we figured out we were serving was a community. The wedding industry is a community. Events takes a community. So we had a lot of fun with that. We have another sister who's an RN. She has nothing to do with any of it. She just helps us when we're sick. But so we had my, you know, my brother, my parents, myself, and our other sister, and we worked our tails off to build a reputation in St. Louis. And by the way, St. Louis has a stigma, right, of being a big city. We are rural country folk. We actually grew up, our parents raised us, about 40 miles south of St. Louis. So, you know, so deer's our thing. Not big skyscrapers. But we're definitely, everyone knows where St. Louis is. So we reference ourselves as St. Louis. And that is the market that we started serving. So then Jeremy, who is my brother and I adore, but because he's my brother, I can find his and talk about his weaknesses as well. Brilliance isn't his weakness. He saw this vision with the company, and he decided to go ahead and franchise another market. And then franchise another market. We got up to four, and we're like, this is hella hard. We can't do this. We need people on the ground, you know, if we're going to have those markets and run them and serve the community the way that the community deserved to be served. You have to have feet on the ground. So back in end of June, 2019, we got notified that Perfect Wedding Guide was going to close. And we're invested. This is what we do. So Jeremy, we had a family meeting. And Jeremy, my parents, everybody agreed that we should go ahead and buy the national brand. So we went from starting 9 years ago in one market to now having an accountability and a responsibility for 131 as a family who now has to run a national brand. And I'm really proud of that. And it was really scary. But the beautiful thing about us making that decision was as a franchise then became licensee and now national representation, we knew because we did exactly what Jack Phelps did for Cincinnati in one market. And then we were trying to duplicate that in other markets. So we were able to say, this is what everybody needs. And evolution and change are necessary to provide everybody what they need, right? So we are able now, we actually didn't close until the acquisition was in November of 2019, right before COVID. That was fun. So we had our timeout too. And during the timeout, we've been working vigorously on improvements and evolution to benefit everyone because we are a resource. We're not just here for our vendors, we're here for our couples too. We have a huge responsibility to connect both. We have a huge responsibility to make sure that we're providing the best services available, the best vendors to our couples across the nation now. And we're really proud of what we're doing and we're working hard and we're evolving along the way. But the fact that we started out in one market, we truly worked in the trenches and got to see what that was like so that we can listen when Tim says, hey, we need to do this. What do you think about that? It is so nice. I hope that there's an appreciation. I know there's an appreciation, but I have an appreciation for hearing him when he asks questions or when Greg has a question, and I'm able to say, I'm hearing you. We're going to implement. We're going to make changes as they're needed. So here we are for vendors. New website being developed. We're still in the development process, but we know every single thing from trial and error, from being not in the driver's seat, but in the passenger seat going, we need to turn right. Right now we're in the driver's seat and we can do that for every single market across the US. So my role has evolved from serving vendors, producing local shows in one market, you know, having people online and doing email marketing and things of that nature, to now having a national responsibility to make sure and to be accountable for clients, which would be our vendors, that we partner with to put them on a platform nationally speaking so they can have that national exposure and that national growth. And then also the other responsibility is to make sure that all of my, you know, licensed markets have everything they need so they're set up for success in their local market. It's imperative to have a strong partnership with our market representation. And I will tell you that there's been a few moments where, you know, it's a big decision when you decide who you're going to put in the marketplace. These people, this group, they are a team, family-backed as well, and they were the perfect people to bring in to serve you. And I know from talking to them, we've become friends. They genuinely want to serve their community, so I'm really proud of that. One of the things that we do is we do a lot of homework. We're kind of nerdy like that. And we do a lot of looking at who you're serving so we know how to best position you. So we know for every single market who your target is. We've got, on average, we've got couples that are engaged for 17 months. 145 guests is the average attendance, right? So we know who you're serving. Approximately, you know, I can't see that hot pink very well from over here. Approximately 17,000 is how many weddings you have here for 2019. So 2020 is going to be a really interesting number. I will say though, following those reports, we're actually looking at double the number of weddings for 2021. Does everybody know that? I mean, has everybody been following that to see that you're about to get really busy? So it's really important to be preparing right now, being very decisive about what you're doing now to position yourself for 2021 so you don't get ran over. So this is an average, 26,800 and some change. That's an average of what people are spending for their wedding. This is specific to your market. Now, we use weddingreport.com for all of our data that we provide. So if you don't have a subscription to that, I recommend it. It's a great place to get your information. We know, again, from what we do in our nerdy positions, that engaged couples are not just going to wedding shows. They're not just going online. They're going to a lot of different avenues. They're going through a lot of different avenues to decide who they're choosing. So what you have that's beautiful here is the opportunity to go to a professional in the marketing and advertising arena and decide where you should be positioned, right? Delegation is one of the biggest keys to success. Let's see. That basically says the same thing. 91% of our couples are using multiple sources of, you know, resources in order to plan their wedding. So again, it's about deciding a plan, creating your plan, and then implementing your plan. And delegation is huge, because I know enough to tell you how social media needs to be handled in order for you to be successful with that. I don't do it, though. That's not what I do. You know, I know email campaigns are powerful, you know, and nerdy details and stats as to why that's so important that you do that. But I don't implement. I find professionals. We have a professional team, you know, at our national, which has now moved from Lake Mary, Florida to St. Louis. We have people in place that take care of those pieces. Because as you all are in different industries and different facets of the wedding business, right, you do different pieces, taking care of your engaged couples. You're working in your business. Let us work on your business. That's the idea, to work together, because it's a partnership. What else we got? I can't see from here. I think we're ready to move on. Can't see that pink. I don't need to. It's okay. I do better without it. So I know that Tim and Greg both touched a lot on what they can do under the TEC marketing brand. A lot of that is going to work in conjunction and hand in hand with you being online with Perfect Wedding Guide. I know that I didn't know until I came here and spent some time how much they truly care, how brilliant they are in connecting everybody. You know, we've went through some trial and error with who to put in the right seats. And we know that we have leaders in your industry to represent you now. So I'm really, really proud of the partnership that we have. And I know that this market is going to flourish. So thank you for having me. I'll hand it over.
I want to introduce the team to you, if I may. Rhonda's online, as I told you earlier on. She's out there talking to everybody that's watching online. So Rhonda Griffin, she's going to be taking care of the majority of the TEC marketing pieces. Emily Monifo is right here. Emily, say hi to Emily. She is also going to work as a specialist in the marketing side of things for TEC. Kirsten Bryant. Kirsten's back here. Kirsten is with our event services company that we didn't even mention yet. So lots of stuff going on. Kirsten also manages the Galleria Event and Conference Center that is in the Event Connections building in Dayton. Michelle Stewart is over here. Michelle, she is our digital resource coordinator. And as you get back into PWG, if you need help getting your page put together, Michelle's going to be one of the people that you're going to go to, and she'll say, let me show you how to get this done, and I'll do it for you, okay? Jessica DiPerna, Jessica right here. So if you ever get a bill in the mail, it's her fault because she does the accounting, all right? And I think that is the entire team, is it not? It is. All right. So to close up, just a couple things. We have a vendors group as well on Facebook. Emily, if you could jump to that real quick. And I'd like you all to get on that today. Go back one. There we go. It's the PWG Greater Cincinnati, Dayton, and Northern Kentucky Professionals. Okay, so get on the Facebook, join that group, so we can talk and learn and grow together. Okay? All right. 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 The PWG site Facebook page for the couples is, oh my gosh, PWG Dayton Northern Kentucky. No, Cincinnati Northern Kentucky Dayton. I think I can't remember. We've. Say that one more time.
You're on my video right now. So it's okay. Perfect Wedding Guide Cincinnati and N, Kentucky, and Dayton. So the N is just an N, not North.
Right. Okay. Thank you.
You're going to see emails coming out that'll explain. PWG before was in a group, and that group, a lot of you are part of, moved. It got changed from being PWG, so we had to start a group from the ground up. But that is the intention of that. It's just for us to, as a community, talk with each other. But to brides, there's a total different page, and we are going to be doing some really neat things called carousel ads that we, St. Louis, has been doing it, that we're going to be doing. That makes Facebook a lot more affordable for people and stuff. So we don't expect you to, there's just so much information coming at you. Just go on Facebook and look at, on Facebook, we're going to be sending out emails. We'll get to know some things. It's just way too complex to explain it. I do want to say, though, there are specific things. Kirsten is going to be coordinating. If you are interested in being a sponsor at this with something, Kirsten's the point person for that. We are going to have people speak. We're going to have different people speak. We're in B&I. B&I is a certain business group thing. We're going to do a little bit of their model where certain vendors may have time to speak about themselves, and we'll get to know each other. Emily's writing the agenda, coordinating things, and did this. Michelle's there to help with the website. Rhonda's helping with social media. All of these people cross over, and it's a great team of people. So just we want to be able to coach you and help you, and you'll see more new things coming out. So let's just communicate. So
super. All right. Well, you know you're going to win something, right? There's always an opportunity to win some things. So what are we going to give away today, Kirsten?
Four flower arrangements.
So the flower arrangements, compliments of Steve Smith and the Flower Man. Aren't those beautiful? They are. Jeff Hill, take one home to your wife. You've won one. Fred, are you married? Absolutely. Take one home to your wife. Destiny. We'll put her back in for something else. Okay, we'll give it to Crystal then. Okay? And then one more. One more is going to Deb. Deb O'Dell. Okay? Give those guys a hand. But wait, there's more. We've got two tickets to our next luncheon to be determined date-wise. So this is Tom. Tom, where are you? All right, and Chrissy. So Tom and Chrissy.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you, thank you.
You're welcome. And then last but not least, I believe, this is...
The family package.
Okay. A year?
Yeah, a year. Yeah.
This is a whole year? Okay, so if you didn't notice driving in, this is not a free visit. Okay, there is an admission because of all the stuff that they have. So this is a family pass for an entire year. Compliments of Pyramid Hill and Mika. You've got it, girl.
Ah, I feel good. I knew
that I would not. We are glad you took time to come out and talk. We're going to be here to talk if you want to talk some more, and we'll be in touch soon. God bless you. Have a great afternoon.
So good. I got you.
Oh, there's golf cart tours. Don't forget that. If you want to see the grounds, head down the hill. They're lined up out there. Have some fun with that.